I don't like.
Why is the Trevor? The camera's really not centered.
It's to cut the glare.
Lolly, could you punch Hoban gently in the face?
But it's not centered.
Nah.
It's because of the Twitch chat makes it look uncentered.
Wait, why?
If he was, is it uncentered?
Oh yeah. It's sort of. It looks weird.
It's fine. It's all right.
It's good. This is good. Leave it like that. Leave the chat like that.
Yes, Bay.
Because,
leave.
Like, then I can see both of their hands, and I can see. The thing. I can see thing.
Man, it's a struggle. You have a,
you know,
few
what? I think I'm going to announce it now, publicly. I think I'm going to ARG Atlantic City. Your boy Bass Lolly, who's supposed to be packing it in. Oh, no way. No way.
I actually can't dye my eyebrows blonde. The place I went to get my hair done.
Hey, Jim.
Told me that they wouldn't do it because it's a risk that
two
if
things.
They bleach gets in my eyes,
dinner.
Then I go blonde.
A, let's go to dinner. B,
I said I would risk it. But
can I get deck lists on these guys?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
What happened?
Huh?
What happened?
So for this feature match, I wanted to give it like a, I wanted to do a well done. So we're getting their deck lists, mainly their side decks, just so we can, you know, in between games we can speculate.
So you said, I don't know what his name is, but he's playing fat?
Giordano Ibrahim.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, no, Patrick, of course, is playing Mermel. So, okay, I think
wasn't
the
that the guy that invented that deck, basically?
Who?
Giordano.
I mean, he played it a lot. Oh, okay.
He, like, so got, like, first in Swiss or something? With something.
Yeah, I think at 1ARG. So this is cool. So Patrick, Giordano Ibrahim. So this is cool. Patrick is teching one or two copies of a card called Card Advance. It comes out in the new battle pack. And basically, you can rearrange the top five cards of your deck, and then you can tribute summon in addition to your normal summon or set this turn. So definitely has a lot of synergy with Sylvan's. I don't really know, like, the application of the tribute summoning in this deck, but I guess we'll find out.
So, yeah, it's just to rearrange the top five.
Mm-hmm. So, Giordano starts with Summon Bear Tenki. So, if that set is a Koma Shroomu, well, it's gone now, but he has the window to drop Sage Koya, which he does not, so I would assume he doesn't have it here. Yeah, of course. Okay, so we have their decks.
So Pat ended up doing that.
Yeah, so Sylvan's versus Super Hot Fire, YPFL.
Is that what it says?
That's what it says.
Super, should be the Super Hot crew.
Yeah. Lolly is that under Desmond Renessa. That's funny. Anyway. Okay, so he plays himself. I actually just hate that joke.
See, one... I guess way this kind of backfired is Patrick played or looked at the top five cards and rearranged them according to, like, assuming he was going to mill with the mushroom.
Mm-hmm.
And since that got popped by Bear, it almost messes up what he had originally arranged. So, like, cards that he wouldn't want to draw normally, now it's the next card on top of his deck. So that makes his Sylvan Charity significantly weaker.
Right. That's definitely true. Yeah.
Yeah, he's, what, two turns behind or something?
Most likely. I mean, hitting the Koma Mushroom with the bear is akin to hitting, like, a Gear Yarmor.
And the fact that on top of that, he didn't have Sage to drop, like, in response to the bear.
Right.
That was another thing that just went completely wrong.
That definitely would have mitigated Bear's effect in that situation, because the deck would still be stacked enough to where he could resolve Sage Koi. Well, I mean, he has it now. I see, like, a Sage.
A Bandit and a tree.
Bandit, a big tree, a Miracle Fertilizer, a Terraforming, and a Soul Charge.
So he's going to Terraforming here, yeah.
Yep.
Is he playing MSTs? No. Oh, he played what? Double Cyclone?
Yeah. What I heard is we can actually look at it. It looks like Giordano is playing multiples of Double Cyclone.
Donnie, that's not true. There's no guarantee. He could have also just put the cards that he wanted closer to the bottom, and you're not forced to mill five. Like, if there were cards that he wanted to draw, like, because he had charity, he could have put those towards the bottom, and after milling with the mushroom, then have drawn them with charity, and then put back whatever cards he wanted to. You're not forced to mill five.
What is that? Oh, deep prison.
Patrick's playing like no defense.
Oh, wow. He plays like no monsters. Three Mermelo. Oh, card car.
Yeah, he pretty much plays plus one with artifacts. Plus one artifact deck.
Was the observer on the plane or
it was played. So it looks like he tried to resolve a miracle fertilizer and it was responded with torrential. Essentially a
what did he stack with the oh.
So he plays a second one. Yeah, I wasn't actually looking. That was really bad of me. I'm curious as to what he stacked with the thing. Yeah, so there goes the second one. So now, with Giordano's two back row, he has a soul charge bringing back, I think, two trees?
Is it just a tree and a mushroom,
I guess.
This is crazy because he has what? Tanky set, so.
Right. I feel like he really needs. So you probably.
Is it a princess set?
You probably
on top?
Stacked a co mushroom. No, a hermit tree.
Oh, because he assumed he was going to, like, soul charge. Yeah.
I thought it might have been a mushroom to hit the tanky, which leaves him without a known follow up.
Yeah, Pat's pretty far behind. Yeah, because he had it set up now, like, he could have brought the tree back off the soul charge and made a Felgrand and been golden.
Also, Wolfbark is still in his hand, correct?
Right.
So.
Oh, there you go. Well, looks like the follow-up was there all along. And there it is. The question is, if you activate card advance and use Miracle Fertilizer's effect, can you do the tribute summon? No, because you cannot normal summon or set, like, you can't. Do those.
The only type of summon you can do is special summon. Yeah.
Right, when you activate Miracle Fertilizer and summon a monster.
Because as weird as it sounds, Tribute Summon is considered a normal summon.
Right. So hoping to use a lot of his power cards, he's used Double Fertilizer and a Soul Charge, leaving him with only three big, like, juice cards left in his deck, like the two soul charge and the last miracle fertilizer and blaster.
I assume he only plays one nightmare, right? Yeah, just one.
Yeah, and he drew it. He got it.
So yeah, he has it.
Mm-hmm.
Compulse. Oh, that's cool. Banisher?
Yeah, for matchups like these.
Yeah.
We gotta keep that a secret, though. We gotta keep that surprise,
right,
though.
Right.
Giordano's actually been playing this deck a lot on Dueling Network, and...
He's number two.
Oh, is he number two? I know he was just rated high. I don't keep up with the actual ratings.
Don't you actually have to play all day to, like, stay that high?
I don't know about staying that high, but getting that high takes a while.
Yeah, I mean, once you get to a certain point, like, people aren't really passing you. Like, you may get passed, but it's not by a lot.
Yeah.
So once you get to that point, you don't really have to play all day.
Right.
But getting there is the grind.
So I see he's debating on making Karn Gorgon here. And
so
he does.
If that's the case, you think he may have like a fiendish chain that he just set, or
I would.
It's something that he's obviously wanting to protect from MST, or I guess like a mushroom.
Right, especially mushroom. I feel like.
Yeah. Ooh. So.
Yeah, I would assume so. I would assume he has some sort of. Let me check. I would assume he either has. I think he has Fiendish Chain down.
Oh, is he going to tribute for tree?
Giordano also didn't flip Tinky though.
Right. I also think. See, now, Patrick drew a blaster.
Hermit's fire, right?
Yeah, but
see, that's not even. If Patrick tries to use blaster to affect Karen Ground, he can just target something different. So
I feel like Giordano made that play trying to protect Tenki.
Well, no, but he didn't activate Tenki last turn. He could have flipped it and activated it.
So he could have.
He only plays three fire. He only plays three targets for Tenki.
So the other target's in his hand.
Right. Yeah. That'd be the assumption.
That's unfortunate.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's one card in hand.
Yeah, and that's probably the second bear.
This.
So, like, you know, I'm like Dion. I don't really know what Sylvan's do. So.
Well, right now he used Mount Sylvania's effect to tribute the on-field mushroom to stack Sage on top of his deck.
Okay, so what do you think? Like, so I'm pretty sure Patrick's hand is tree and blaster.
He's doing at this point is just digging for just some sort of power card. Like, he's going to get the charity off of this play. I wouldn't be surprised if he just didn't put Princess Sprout on top because he wants to see his next three cards. He may, but...
He's putting it on top, it looks like.
Like, because right now there's no way for him to see. Like, now he's only seeing two cards with charity, so...
Well, we see he has a chalice.
It was MST.
Yeah, MST chalice.
MST chalice.
He does not play MST.
Oh, okay. So what was... Was it Soul Charge, maybe?
I think that's...
I think it's another charity?
Yeah, that's what it looks like. It looks like another charity. Chalice. So I guess what he could do here is he could activate Blaster, and I don't know, that just doesn't seem worth it. I think why he put it on the top was because he wanted to keep the fire in his hand to use with Blaster.
Can he just special Blaster? Does he... I guess he plays Prisons.
He has one.
I mean, I see the because obviously if he gets like fertilizer or something, then he'll still have a princess on top. That way he can make like attempt to make a rank 8 play. But at the same time, in the situation he was in, he didn't really have anything going for him, and it seems like he was trying to make more out of a situation than like reasonable, I guess.
Yeah.
Like, at that point, you probably should have been digging for fertilizer or something to, like, get going. Yeah. Now
so here's the blaster.
Special blaster, yeah.
Yeah.
And wow. Does he have, like, two tanky set or something?
I don't think so.
There could be wiretaps.
Yeah. And that's, like, Giordano means two, so it could be wiretap. It could be Call the Haunted.
Double Cyclone.
If it's called a haunted, that's not good for Patrick.
Yeah, if it's double cyclone.
Yeah, so that was the third bear.
Right. I mean, he would have probably already used the. Yeah. So see, there you go. Now he has a chalice set, so he'll probably end up using the chalice in order to protect himself, or his blaster, or himself.
Protect his soul charge.
Yeah.
He draws it.
Would you save it here, you think, knowing what you're going to draw into?
Who, Patrick?
Yeah.
To save the chalice?
Right.
He's
going to go back to
honestly,
his hand anyway.
Probably, because you have to keep in mind, he didn't search with Tinky one time. So if he searched the Tinky out of his deck, it's not really, it's not doing anything.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But now he can only what, soul charge for two? I see. Still wins with two
he
trees.
He didn't search for the tanky. Okay.
So yeah.
The only scary part for him is going to be the fact that it is a new backer just set. So.
Right. Oh, there it is.
Oh, so there's a soul charge.
Marsh Leaf, and I didn't see the other card.
Another spell card.
Does Patrick main Dark Hole?
Yes. No.
No. Nope. I didn't think so.
Looks like a foolish burial.
Okay. Yeah. It looks like it could be a foolish burial.
Yeah, that's a foolish burial. So it's foolish burial, soul charge, martial leaf, and pop a tree. The only power one of trap that Giordano has used, I think, is Torrential. So
yeah.
Patrick still has a lot to play around.
Well, he probably would have warning last turn.
I mean, yeah, but like he just set one right here.
That's true.
So there's a lot of that.
Even if it's like Torrential or like something like that, it's still.
I mean, he has one of them. He has either Bottomless or Warning. That he just said. The other two can't be Bottomless or Warning because you would have used it on the Blaster.
Right.
And one is almost certainly tanky.
Yeah, he almost certainly would have protected.
Does Giordano play three tanky?
I believe so.
Yeah, he plays three tanky, so one of them probably just is set.
Yeah, he probably just set one of the tankies.
Because he opted not to use Bear's effect after it attacked directly last turn.
So I think he's opting to use Princess. Technically at the top. Oh wait, what is he doing? Oh, he's using it with Sylvania.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
There it is. Oh, it looks like he's gonna try and clear away the new set by the Marshall Leaf in his hand.
Definitely going to hit the new one because he should have a read that that the other one, like one of the other two, is a tanky, and you don't want to risk 50-50 on hitting a dead card. Just go ahead. Take what you're given.
Yeah. So he excavates a Marshall Leaf and a Hoban.
Yep.
He picks the new one.
Ooh.
Oh,
wow. Well, that's not even that bad.
I mean, that's whatever here.
I mean, that's not good. Could live without it.
Yeah.
What is it? Is this going to pop Sylvania?
You know, this could. It could also be like a. Does Giordano play Black Horns?
No.
No. Just no? The one good, really good card.
I wonder if it could be.
Never mind.
Could it just be a Moral Talk?
It could be.
It could be Wiretap.
It could be Compulse.
No. Ah, yeah.
16, then 17 through 30 seconds. You will also acquire points today for the 25.
But don't you just Compulse the Blaster last turn?
To save the
Karen Gorgon. And then you just summon Bear and attack, and Pat can't Soul Charge anymore?
I mean. But at the same time, then you just can't deal with Blaster. Like,
you're
compulsing Blaster, and then it's just that you're still not dealing with it, so.
So we pop the Sylvania. So Patrick's just like, okay, well, I have to use Soul Charge here. So he's going to bring back, he's definitely going to bring back two of the big trees, but which big tree? Oh, well, it looks like he's contemplating Princess Sprout.
Yep. Gives him a guaranteed draw.
Yeah, I can see why he'd do that. For a rank 8 play.
Patrick is thinking about what he wants to target.
Pat's 800.
So he opted to get the Princess Sprout to get the guaranteed draw.
Yeah. So.
Oh.
Well, that's nice.
Good, yes, yes.
That's really good.
So he's basically just going to see the top two.
Yeah, which is.
Chalice. And okay, so he's just going to keep it in that order.
Well, doesn't he draw Chalice?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. He's going to keep it in that order.
And then.
Oh, okay. Yeah, he could also just do the mushroom, not the mushroom, the marsh leaf to. See, but I still think it's probably just stronger to leave it the way it is, because you can make this rank 8 play, and if it doesn't go through, oh no, never mind. I guess you don't have mount anymore. So
yeah, exactly. I mean,
all right. So I could definitely see the leaf being the right play. Yeah. But I
think Pat sees the same thing in the sense that the rank 8 is probably more efficient in this situation than.
I mean, you know one of the back rows is tanky, and the other one is just, it hasn't been, it's been there almost the entire game, so there's a very strong possibility of being on the bluff, so Patrick's taking advantage of that.
Yeah, and with that Chalice too, like, does Giordano even play anything that'll get him out of it? I don't think so. If he just makes Felgrand?
No, not.
He wanted me to give him back the wager.
Oh. Draco sack? Oh, no. Pat's locking him out of the game.
Yeah.
Or... is that one, or is that the other one?
No, this would put the, what are we saying, some moral talk on top of his deck.
This one?
But can't he still, like?
Well, I mean, he's going to mill.
Oh no! This is how he gets Marshal Leaf off the top.
Yeah, yeah.
So he's going to bounce a card, and then he's going to pop another
card. Yep.
So he's probably going to bounce the moral talk here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And bounce the, or and then pop the bear.
Isn't it sort of risky, though? Because can't he just get, like, if one of them's, if he pops a moral talk, he just loses.
Well, yeah, but that's why.
Oh, no, he's Chalice.
Yeah, like, well, he doesn't pop the back row here.
No back row is being popped. Yeah, the Marsh Leaf is going to target a monster.
Right.
And then
Marsh Leaf pops the bear. Right. So this is, I think this is the most correct play in this situation because it.
Oh, wow.
Did he rip that?
Yeah.
The stones.
Oh my god. I guess in that situation, YPFL we lit.
Oh yeah, that guy is one of the YPFL people.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He just YPFL'd all over this guy. That was.
Looks like Patrick just drew a tree.
I feel like, can we acknowledge that a little more? How he just, you know, drew the dark hole? That's crazy. That's insane. What a boss. And he did so casually. He did it like, oh, yeah, well, happened. My God. Yeah, what is going to...
Oh, my God.
Yeah, Patrick concedes instantly.
That was a really, really big swing.
Let's get the face cams. Let's see if Patrick is at all phased.
You know, I wonder if...
No, I guess not.
Maybe Patrick got a little too greedy with that.
Well, if he just went Felgrand, he probably still wins.
Well, no. He in that situation, he could have made a rank 7. He could just made Drago sack and then completely played around Dark Hole as, like, a possible out.
Yeah, but I mean, he had to rip it. I mean...
No, I mean, I understand. But, like, Patrick was at a point in that game where he should have just understood that the only way he was losing that game is by Giordano... just top decking like a perfect out, and he left himself in a situation that gave Giordano a perfect out.
Yeah, that's true.
Where
that's true.
He could have just not done that. He could have made Drago sack and popped the bear, and then like moral talk doesn't do anything to Patrick's field. Like it gets over the the marsh leaf. That's it. So that, like, it was just.
Yeah, that would have left Patrick at 200. Okay,
oh,
fair enough.
We can actually talk about their siding for once.
Oh, yeah. All right, so let's talk about. So here's what we got here. Here are the sides.
Giordano actually sides a lot for this matchup.
Yeah, Giordano sides Necro Valley, Deep Dark, Trap Hole, Maxis, Banisher, Macrocosmos, Solar
Dimensional
Drain,
Fissure.
Dimensional Fissure, Typhoon. So many cards can come in for this matchup, and realistically, Patrickson.
He also puts in Necro Valley. I that's kind of like a toss-up card, but he actually played Luke Feeney on Dueling Network the other night, and he put in he had Necro Valley Banisher and just set
victory.
Up for a turn. Yeah, there's no fertilizers, no soul charges.
What's spiritualism?
That's for Infernity.
Oh, okay.
I don't think we'll be seeing that in here.
It just bounces a set spell or trap, and it can't be
responded
to, so they can't barrier it, so all their traps become dead.
Is Pat just putting in Rivalry and Malkin?
I don't know if Patrick will put Rivalry because he plays tanky, like the tanky bear engine. But I think we might see a lot of, we might see Typhoon, and we'll probably see Malkat. I think that'd be it.
Yeah, is the Encore worth it?
I don't think.
Oh, right, he doesn't ever.
Definitely not.
I don't think this is a matchup Patrick really needs to side heavily for.
Yeah.
For decks like Sylvan's, I don't even think that it's right to side more than maybe 4 or 5 cards for a particular matchup anyway. Because decks like Sylvan's, at the end of the day, they're a combo deck.
Mm-hmm.
And you don't want to take out combo pieces and replace them with, like, cards that are supposed to, like, stunt your opponent's game.
Right.
It's just, you want to make sure that your deck does what it was made to do, and you don't want to, like, mess that up by oversiding.
Well, anyway, it looks like the match started, and Pat starts off with a Lone Fire for Hermit Tree straight away, so...
Oh.
And he hits the Princess without setup off the top. He only runs 2.
That's interesting. I think
Giordano grinning over there. Just can't believe that just happened, I guess.
God, he must have. Never mind.
So Pat makes Alsei here. And with 3 back row, he just passes. So I guess post game 1, I would expect those back row to be a mix of Typhoon, Forbidden Chalice, and Malkat. So Giordano starts off with a card D and 4 back row.
Plus 1.
Now, I think Malkat is really good post-game 1 for Patrick because I'm pretty sure Giordano sided his like wiretaps and stuff out.
Yeah, I'd assume.
Oh, and he just goes for the Typhoon straight away. Okay, and he hits a pretty good card.
He's playing 3 Sanctum, right?
Yeah. What do you think Patrick was trying to hit, Brandon, when he just did that?
You know, the only thing... Yeah, see, I'm not really sure because this play, it seems like it would have been smarter just to hold the MST for a Fiendish Chain.
Mm-hmm.
Like the only thing that I would have thought would, like, my first reaction was Sanctum, but then you hit Sanctum and you get blown out.
Yeah.
Obviously, like, in the end phase of Giordano's turn, you could hit Moral Talk or just Moral Talk. He doesn't play Beagle Talk, but you could hit Moral Talk and it wouldn't do anything. But at the same time, why do you want to MST at Moral Talk? Like, I just blind MSTing like that. I don't know.
Yeah.
No, it just seems like waiting for Fiendish Chain would have been.
If he waited for something like that to be flipped up.
You know, then again.
Maybe, yeah.
Oh, but here's
okay,
the.
So he's a second. So
okay,
that's,
so I guess
that's why
he did it. Now, I hear from Patrick a lot, like, you know, if you have, like, 2 Mexi, always go for the 1-for-1. If you have, like, 2 of any card, always try and. You don't need to get maximum value out of the first one because you'll probably get it out of the second one. I feel like that's a fundamentality he lives by.
I could also see him just I didn't see his hand, but I could also see him just having a malevolent catastrophe also, and he set
number three.
Yeah, see, there's the Phoenix Shane.
Right. He just had a bunch of
continuous
stuff.
I don't know. I just don't agree with the first MSC. The second one was obviously... But yeah, I don't agree with the first MST. I think the second one was obviously completely necessary. You can't have mackerel on the field. But
yeah.
the first one just... I feel like you could have waited and activated the effect, and worst case scenario is it gets Phoenix Shane. And I guess Sanctum is worst case scenario, but like by end phase MSCing, you're not playing around Sanctum.
Right.
So I don't know. I don't know what his reasoning for that
Bates
was.
On. He plays two of himself.
The third.
Okay, I gotta stop making that joke. You're right, Brandon. Brandon's giving me like a dirty look
just
over here.
Just propagating it.
Or behind the booth, he's just like, nah, I don't know you anymore.
That's true. Someone said he hit Compulse anyways on the MST.
That's hindsight, though.
Yeah.
Like, if you set forward back row and you're blind MSTing, like, that's, like, congratulations, you hit Compulse. That was one of the few cards that were out, so, you're a monster on board. But at the same time.
Oh, my God.
Could you score?
Would Pat know that he's on very little, like, monsters, very small artifact engine? It's like round 9, so maybe.
Well, it's not just that. Like he saw Moral Talk game 1.
He might think he might be like playing like Bagel Techs and stuff.
I'm pretty sure Patrick's familiar with the fat deck.
Yeah.
It was popular at Nationals, so I'm pretty sure he's familiar with it. So. He knows.
Makes of dust.
Majority so of the cards.
He has Dust and Alsei with a rivalry set. Do you think Patrick is at all concerned with whether or not it'll conflict?
Well, it's chained up, though, so he can just
Yeah.
Duality.
Now, I'm not even 100% how this would work. Could Patrick activate Alsei and then chain Rivalry and call Dragons, and then Alsei's off the field and it would resolve? Is that how that works?
Because does chain stop?
Because rivalry
activations.
Rivalry would be chain link 2. No, it negates.
No,
it
negates the
attack. So rivalry would be chain link 2, and so it would resolve first.
That's a good
and
question.
And then Alsei's effect. So maybe that's why he made Stardust, is because he's setting up for that play.
Yeah.
What did he get off the duality?
Card. Double Cyclone.
Oh, okay.
Is what he got? Because he had another card. So.
Okay, that's a lot of factor.
Yeah, he sets 3 more.
That's, holy cow. They're going to draw nice. If Pat wins this game.
So, Pat...
another Upstart.
Yeah, Pat plays Upstart Goblin is the card name. I'm not going to call it Patrick anymore.
It lets you draw a card and pay, give your opponent 1,000 life points.
Unless you're Alex Medina.
Yeah.
You just give your opponent...
Didn't he win that game, too?
Yeah, he did. Yeah, he did, as I sound depressed.
It wasn't against you, was it?
No.
Oh, okay, I was going to say.
Man, he would have needed that card. It was against me, man. Shout out to my boy Christian Gorgeous over here.
Christian Gorgeous.
YPFL.
Is that my new name?
Christian? Yeah. Yeah, it is. It is now. Two. Giordano's up a game. Did he attack?
Yeah.
With Stardust?
I don't know, to be honest. So... He targeted the old back row.
Is there a reason to not negate now?
The only thing, I don't know. Giordano doesn't. It doesn't even matter if Giordano sides it. Patrick could all. I mean, not Patrick. Giordano could have Deep Dark Trap Hole set for when it comes back. And Patrick could fear debunk. But obviously, you have to negate that because it's. I'm pretty sure that was the rivalry.
Yeah, it was. Yeah.
So. I mean, you don't really have a choice to, but I mean, those are the cards you have to worry about. It's like Deep Dark and.
Yeah, are life points correct? Can we find out if life points are correct?
How many times do you attack with Stardust?
I think they're awful.
I'm not sure. That's why. Otherwise, it just
has.
I don't even know if he attacked.
I think
once.
He attacked twice.
Can you find out? Thank you. Love you.
Oh.
Lolly Hoban is way too pedo. Nah. I would know. Okay, so that's an interesting looking fertilizer. Is it drawn on?
No, it's just super.
Oh.
Oh, it might be drawn on.
No, it's just the light.
Dude, I'm telling you, it looks like a banana.
Patrick 100% doesn't play drawn on cards.
Yeah, I would assume not.
Is
it
6K?
Is it 6K? Okay, so there you go. All right, so Giordano attempts to activate Bottomless, and he negates the Stardust. So in an open game state after the chain resolves, Giordano activates Sanctum. Yu-Gi-Oh! Duelist Bowden in the chat.
Oh, Brandon Wakely's awake.
Brandon Wakely, the biggest fan.
I love Bowden.
Me too. I wish he was my fan. So, okay, he summons some Mortal Talk here and aims to get rid of the fertilizer, which is, you know, essentially by popping the Hermit Tree. So this Alsace is still all tied up. Hashtag all tied up.
this Stardust is actually just getting a lot of value.
Oh, yeah.
It's taking out a double Cyclone and a
Bottomless.
It's actually just forcing Giordano to play an extra card to respond to Patrick.
Ooh.
So he gets tanky here. So here's another card, like, that, I mean, he could get Bear, he could activate it to bid out the Stardust again, then activate another card to potentially clear Zalsei.
Now, the question here is, does Patrick just, like, as soon as Giordano summoned the Bear, you can't really rivalry. Oh, okay.
So he goes Book of Moon, flips a Bear. And so he could flip rivalry.
I think you have to flip. Yeah, you flip rivalry right here.
So I think the other set is a Chalice. So this would force Giordano to pop with Bear, and he chalices because he's going to keep the Bear. And then the other Bear, I mean, he could just summon the other Bear and make a Tiger King. Oh, he concedes for time. Okay.
Why would...
Interesting.
Oh, a draw just gets them both out of the tournament.
I mean, yeah. And Giordano just kind of figured it would take too long. And
yeah, game three.
He just weighed his options, I suppose. Okay, well.
Do you take soul charges out with 2 minutes on the clock?
I'd assume Patrick wouldn't take soul charges out because the deck is so strong with it, but I feel like he would take upstart
out.
Well,
of course, yeah.
There's no way Giordano's life points couldn't have been at 85 because there's no reason.
No, it was at 6.
Oh, he did it backwards.
I thought Patrick's
was
6.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, Patrick's was written down as 6.
Oh, okay,
so
yeah.
So I was about to say, because with rivalry on the field, there would have been no reason to scoop when you're up like that. You could just win in time.
I think Pat was up a little bit.
Yeah, but I mean, if that's true, then this is definitely the right decision. It's actually good to see people acknowledging how much time's left and having enough awareness to go into the next game. Like, it's actually as good for both players. Because, like we already said, another draw knocks both of them out of the tournament, and that's obviously not what either one of these players wants. So,
right.
It's good to see that awareness.
Might as well have one of them go on than neither.
If you're at 8,000, it's not a draw, right?
Nope.
It's like sudden death.
Right.
And that's
I think I'm pretty sure it's a draw.
No,
here.
I think if you're in game three and that happens, I think you still play it out. Pretty
and that's
sure.
That's
for Konami.
Is it? I don't know.
The thing that stinks about this too is Pat had he done something different game one, would have probably won 2-0.
Yeah.
Used to win three games.
I mean, it's.
Uh-oh.
Is it Mermelos at 5?
So it looks like Giordano finally decides, hey, I think I should go first.
Now, see, this is actually very important. If Giordano hurries up and sets, like, plays his cards and sets them before it goes into time, there's only 30 seconds on the clock, so essentially he's getting an extra turn in time.
They probably have a minute or two extension, I bet.
Well, no, it's right up here on the. It's on the.
Yeah.
But yeah, if Giordano just sets everything and passes right now, Patrick has. Oh.
Looks like he didn't end his turn fast enough.
I mean, there's.
Oh, yeah.
I guess they're counting it as turn one, whatever.
Well, that's time in the round. Shout out to Jonah Ritzo.
Has it?
So Pat
so
plays.
He gets
charity.
One, 3 and 5.
Yeah.
Pat gets turn 1, 3, and 5.
I guess they. It looked to me they called time on the feature match prematurely, but as it looks right now, it looks like. Patrick will get the last turn, so.
Which is really good for Patrick.
Yeah.
Because it gives him a turn to solo charge, then it gives him a turn to attack with the team.
Yeah, he essentially has an extra turn to attack. Mm-hmm. Plus, he started out at a plus one. I guess Giordano summoned Mermilio, so that kind of mitigates
I think Giordano's on, like, almost pure air. He's, like, freaking out.
Is he?
Yeah, he's, like, moving around a ton, touching everything.
Yeah, he always plays like that.
Oh,
he's
does
just,
he?
Oh,
okay.
Yeah.
He just sort of freaks out.
Yeah, I don't know. He's just. Some people get fidgety. Jeff Jones is another one of the players that just moves around a lot when he's playing.
And we all know how everyone loves Jeff Jones. Hope he isn't watching this at home. That would be... But I love Jeff Jones. Yeah. Pat has 9 cards in hand. How does he lose? How does he lose? Well...
Well...
Well, there's 3 back row, so...
And a Mermelo.
Yeah, that's a...
Yeah, literally all Giordano has to do is hang on tight, I think.
Can we move the chat to the right? So we can see Patrick's hand?
Yeah, let's do that. Hey, Trevi, can we get off the face cam?
Yeah, so that way we can see Pat.
Okay, I'm getting a phone call again. Oh, you're going to have to mute me for this one, dog. No, I'm just joking.
You're 2, right?
Hello? Hey, what's up?
Uh-oh.
What's good, dog?
Alright.
I'll just mute everyone.
Okay.
And we're back.
And we're
live.
We're back. Wait, I'm getting a call from Denton, Texas.
Okay, well, don't answer.
Who lives in...
But I'm curious. I can't help it.
Hello? Hi. I don't know. Why don't you come watch and find out?
Get off the phone.
Is it... Am I muted? I can't tell.
I don't really know. I'm just going to keep talking. I may be talking to myself.
Oh, so apparently Giordano, duality in the compulsory?
Is that like on the stream or something?
Yeah.
Shout out to my boy.
Yeah,
all right, shout out to my boy Michael Clazel. I grew up my beard just for him. okay, all right. Back to the action here. Pardon my interruption. Thanks, phone.
For your Mike Wilbon.
Don't look at me like that, Brand Dion. Okay, so... What did I miss? What did he put back on top with charity? That's pretty important.
It was a mushroom and another guy.
So what did... What happened with the compulse? Did he just compulse an attack?
I think Pat's down on life.
Yeah, I think it... Otherwise, I don't see how compulse got engraved. It just seems like... Giordano compulsed monster attack for 16, and now he's playing defensive. So,
and
Patrick should be at 64 to Giordano's 8,000.
Yeah,
I think so.
Pat has 5 monsters.
Yeah, that Pat is just really stuck. Yeah, he compulses
one time, like
oh, if
five
if finishing
things.
Gets in here, like it's a wrap.
Well, it's not just that. Like Patrick has five monsters, so you have to wonder how much is there that's actually just left to hit. Like, yeah, see,
it's absolutely nothing.
Yeah.
He shakes his head. You can see it over at the table. He's just
here's the handshake.
That's pretty miserable. Yeah, and he offers the handshake with that.
Yeah, that's
it's crazy.
Whoa. And Giordano just throws his back row at Patrick and says, well, that was a good game of Yu-Gi-Oh. So I guess you were right. He was fidgeting around because he actually just opened really poorly.
Yeah.
Like, yeah. And you can see Patrick is just a little bit tilted from that. He's just shocked that none of his five cards were plants.
Well, I mean, like, I called it before even milled. It's just he drew so many monsters. Like, if his build from Nationals didn't change very much, if you remember, he played very minimal Sylvans. Like, he tried to cut down on the unnecessary Sylvans. So if he opens with a handful of monsters and then, like, all those aren't in his deck to mill, there's not that many that he could have hit.
I mean, yeah, that's true.
And even if he would have hit one.
Yeah, what does it do? Like
what one does he need to hit to come out of that?
I think. Yeah, I don't know. I guess realistically there wasn't anything like any real plant he could. He would have to hit like multiples.
Oh, poor Pat. Oh God.
Yeah, he's just really. I think he's just really. You can see it on his face. Just the face of defeat.
Yeah.
No, that's just the face of when Desmond tries to talk to you about the match.
Oh, okay.
That's
well,
Desmond's talking to him right
there
now.
There you go. Karakuri God, 16. Desmond Johnson, everybody. No, he's
okay.
Not. I don't think so, right? Is it Desmond top?
No, I don't think so.
Do you know Desmond's record, Joe Giuliano? Joe Giuliano, dueling superhero. Do you know Desmond's record?
I think he drew in the first
game. He drew in?
I either was over or
so. Yeah, looks
like
where are you going?
Yeah. Oh, Pat did?
He gave us a little bit.
Okay.
He was Sanctum and he could
give us a little bit. Like,
right.
Like
just go without us, it's fine.
And then you could hit the Hermit Tree, then he was on top, and he could trigger the Sage. He would be able to bottle us because the Hermit Tree needs to resolve, and then he could try and rivalry Sage him up.
Well,
so